All right. Now, let's go to tubes. Tube baits are the number one bait on Lake Erie, bar none, for catching smallmouth bass. I believe that I was one of the first ones to catch fish on tubes in the late 70s. Having been in the Bassmaster Tournament Trail, I brought them back to Lake Erie and caught them way back when, and they have consistently caught smallmouth bass. Let's look at some tube fishing.
Size. He's bigger than I thought, and he just broke my line. And if I can chase him down, nice little bass, maybe 1.75 pounds. Not a decent fish. I guess he was a little bigger than I thought. I better just reach in and grab him. So turn him loose. All right. What I'm trying to do, there's one. Look at that. On a drop, he hit it. There he is, coming up. That water is just so crystal clear. He's a little guy. Him I can swing in. But now over the last few days of catching these guys, I've been out to these spots and they have just been monsters. And of course, we bring the camera along. They got smaller. They really were bigger yesterday. Really, you should have been here yesterday. He's here 1,000 times. Okay, we'll let him go. But they're starting to come, so I'm starting to be happy. I'm using a white tube because the bass are just feeding like crazy on minnows, big schools of minnows that are just about everywhere right now in the lake. They're breaking on the surface for them. And, oh, we just got bit again right on the way down. You saw, and there's one sitting right there next to it. He's chasing it. Oh, my gosh. I wish the camera, I have my Polaroid glasses on. But as I dropped that down there, a big brown form just chased my tube. Because this white tube, oh, a bunch of big ones with them. Look at that. Oh, folks, if you could see what I see. Look at that. I'm trying to get them to the surface. Can you? I don't know if the camera can see that. But there are 3 big bass together. That was wild. Oh, that gives me goosebumps. But look at that. That's a beautiful fish. There's a nice one. Oh, yeah. Look at that, folks. Look at that beautiful bass. Oh, yeah. All right. Yes, sir. Oh, man. Beautiful. That's what we've been waiting for. And then it came up 2 or 3 at a time that time. Yep. Oops, almost. Come on, big boy. Yeah. There we go. All right. Yeehaw! And that's what it's all about. Look at that beautiful bass. Yes, sir, I will let you go. And his friend was with him, trying to grab that jig out of his mouth while he was swimming with it.
Oh, yeah, it feels like he's got some weight to him. Yeah, it is. Oh, that's a nice fish. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, this is when my heart starts to shake. Starts to beat a little faster when you see that old brown shape down there in the water. Oh, baby. Oh, yeah. Come on. Come on. Come on, big smallmouth. Oh, that is a nice. That is a nice smallmouth. It'll jump for us. Oh, he had a boy. Had a boy. Oh, he's choking. Come on. Come on. Nice and easy. Come on. One more jump. Had a boy. Come on. Come here. Come here, you. Come here, you. It's that long reach. Oh, yes. Beautiful fish. All right. Nice. My heart beats just as fast on every fish I catch. I think from the first time I caught a little bluegill when I was a kid to catching a big smallmouth like this. Beautiful. We caught that last fish on a tube jig. Now, many people are introduced to the tube jig each year and are not really sure how to rig it. It's kind of different. What we want to do is we want to put the jig head, which for a tube jig is a teardrop-shaped jig. We want to put it inside of this body. Now, the way we want to do that is we need to lubricate a little bit, put a little saliva in there, a little bit of lubricant of some type, some Berkeley Power Bait or whatever. Slide it inside. Now, we're going to work it in very carefully, work it in all the way so it's butted all the way against the front of the lure, all the way like this. Make sure that your little tentacles are out of the way. And once it's all the way in, then we push down on the front of it right there, and we expose our line tie. Then we tie our line onto it. Most of the other ones I'm going to show you, the line is already tied on, but on a tube jig, we do that. We put the jig head inside of the tube first and then tie the line onto it. That's a tube jig.
All right, let's talk about one of the best summer patterns on Lake Erie for smallmouth bass. That's fishing little high spots or rises in the bottom. They don't have to be anything more than a foot or two off the bottom, and they don't even have to be sharp drops. They're just little bits of depth changes. You might be fishing 30 feet of water, and you come along an area that goes to 29 or 28, a little bit of a rise, falls back off, easy, slow taper. Those areas will consistently hold big smallmouth bass in the summertime. Now, I mentioned 30 feet. This might be at 40 or 50 feet that you're looking for these patterns as well. But one of the things to use on them, tubes and reapers, a great way to catch them. This next piece of video is going to show you what I'm talking about.
Fishing a summer pattern of just slightly raised bottoms. In other words, just a slight hump off the bottom, a crack, even a slight depression of the surrounding areas will hold fish during the summer, boy, like nothing else. They'll suspend around it. They will just relate to it. And even the surrounding areas, maybe 50 yards or 100 yards on either side of it. It's a great pattern. I'm fishing with tubes, white ones, and one that I call goldfish, as well as throwing reapers now and then for those that are straggling behind every once in a while, throwing that, and even having a topwater bait ready because they're busting on top. Whoa! My bail just flipped, and did I get them? Oh, I missed them. My bail flipped. Let's see if I can do that while I'm talking to you. And get them again. And they're suspended now, and we're in the midst of thunderstorms. All right. There he is. Oh, how clear this water is. A bad fish. A couple pounds. I'll take a couple pound fish any day, because if it wasn't here, I'd be in front of a computer answering the phone. And a 2 pound bass is better than a phone call any day of the week. All right. Beautiful. Love it. The reaper strikes again. Hey, after you catch a fish, if he messes your bait up, you'll have the hook all the way through. Just without messing up your bait too bad, you can just take your line, pull your hook back through like that, and then feed it up into the eye. What you want to do is make sure with the reaper that it is on the hook as straight as possible. And that's pretty straight. So you don't want it to twist. Line twist will really mess you up when fishing a reaper. So make sure that's nice and straight on it. Continually changing the depth of your bait, making sure it's either on the bottom where you want it to be, or in relation to where you see them on the graph. You know, most of the fish I'm seeing right now are on or near the bottom. Earlier they were suspended, and we were throwing them and catching them while they were suspended, but right now they seem to be near the bottom. So I'm just trying to put my reaper down there and catch that one big monster for the day. Oh, there he is, right there. He comes right up on. He's coming up for a jump. Look at him out there. Oh, beautiful. Man, oh man, I think he's bigger than I thought he was. I only have 6 pound test on this one, so I'm going to make sure I get him up. But wow. I don't think he knew he was hooked. Just absolutely beautiful. Here he comes. Yes, he is bigger than I thought he was. I thought he was only like maybe a pound and a half, and he's 3. And he's pooped. Yeah, it was a great fight. Wow. Yes, sir. Way to end the show. I love it. I love it. Little pumpkin reaper with a chartreuse tip on his tail. And the end result, a beautiful smallmouth bass like that. Look at the colors on him. Wow. Isn't that gorgeous? Let's let him go back because he had a good fight. and we'll follow them right back down to whoever Jones's locker. Thank you, Mr.